To talk about insulin resistance and gluconeogenesis. Now, first of all, let's talk about what gluconeogenesis is. Gluco means glucose, that's sugar. Neo means new, and genesis means the creation of. So gluconeogenesis is the new creation of glucose made by your liver, and it's stimulated by a hormone called glucagon, and it's inhibited or turned off by your favorite hormone called insulin, which is triggered by more glucose from the diet. But what happens with gluconeogenesis is that the body is making new sugar out of non-carbohydrate sources. So it's making sugar out of protein, out of fat, out of ketones. Why? Because there's always a certain amount of sugar that your body does need, and it's not required to come from the diet. Your body can make it from other sources. But what happens when you have insulin resistance, things kind of become a little crazy because insulin resistance is a kind of a precursor for prediabetes. And when you have prediabetes, you have insulin resistance, but also you're going to have insulin resistance when you become a diabetic. So when someone starts to cut out their carbohydrates because they're a prediabetic or a diabetic, or they're on the ketogenic diet, because they finally realize that diabetes or prediabetes is high sugar and having a high carb diet contributes to that and it makes it worse. They finally had that realization. So now what they're going to do is cut the carbs out. But when they check their sugars, sometimes their sugar is too high. Now, how can that be? They're not eating any sugar. Well, if you're not eating any sugar and you have high sugar, that means it must be coming from gluconeogenesis. Now, the question is, why would the body be making more sugar? Well, because the sensor, the turnoff signal, the off switch is apparently not there in sufficient quantities. So obviously you don't have enough insulin because the insulin resistance is so strong. You have so much resistance that insulin is not able to get through. And so your body is sensing a low insulin situation. So it's just going to make more sugar. So if the blood sugars are that high, then that's the reason why. Oh, I made a rhyme. Just give it more time, keep doing keto, keep doing fasting, and eventually the insulin resistance will improve to the point where your liver won't keep making sugar anymore. So we really have two situations. We have insulin resistance over here, and then we have the pancreas making insulin over here. The beta cell in the pancreas makes insulin. And so the pancreas cell will make more insulin if you're eating more sugar. Why? Because it's trying to compensate for that. And as you're making more insulin, the insulin resistance will become more resistive simply because you have too much insulin because your carbs are too high. So there's really two situations going on. So here's what happens. Okay. So you have this insulin resistance, and then eventually you become a prediabetic. Now that's where the blood sugars are starting to creep up to a certain amount, not astronomical, but just a certain amount. So obviously, there's not enough insulin to push it down because of the insulin resistance. So this goes on for a period of time as a pre-diabetic, and then eventually you become a diabetic where the blood sugars start going really out of control. And that is a major deficiency of insulin, both because we have the insulin resistance and because the pancreas cell now can no longer compensate and make this excessive amount of insulin to keep your blood sugars in check. So we have a situation where we have insulin resistance and a complete exhausted pancreas. And if the person keeps doing more and more carbs, then the doctors will eventually give you insulin on top of that. So, I mean, the whole thing could be prevented and treated just by getting off these darn carbs, but that never happens. We use these medications to manipulate these values, unfortunately. The whole point of this video is to tell you that we also have another situation involved in diabetes, and that is this gluconeogenesis, this liver making sugar. Okay, so this goes beyond the carbs in the diet. So when you're diabetic, a major contributing factor to your blood sugars is gluconeogenesis. The liver is making new sugar. So the solution or the answer to this is number one, get on healthy keto, cut the carbs down, make sure you provide all the nutrients and the phytonutrients to counter all the complications that occur, and then give it time. because it's going to take time to reverse this, and it may take months to even a couple years. So don't give up. If you run into a barrier, find the solution and stick with it.
So if you're enjoying my content, which I hope you are, and you're applying this knowledge to your health, and you have a success, I'd really appreciate you sharing your success story. So click the link down below to my website where you can upload your success story so you can help inspire others.